Fair enough. Let's talk about you. 915 days you have been our WWE. Undisputed Universal Champion. No need to print the legend. The reality has become legendary enough. You have superseded hyperbole. Congratulations. Let me tell you something about me, about your WrestleMania opponent, something you may know, you may not know. For some, you have become this impossible mountain to climb, but that's kind of my thing. Really, if you think about it, he can't be any more than Randy's understudy. There's no way that Cody will survive Stardust. Goalposts moved again. There's no way that 10,000 people would pay to see me and my buddy's little indie show. And ever since then, the goalposts have continuously moved, and I continuously punch it through the uprights. So for everybody else, Roman Reigns might be impossible. Just not for me.
Hey, he's good. You know what I mean? That was good. That's like you've been rehearsing that all week or something. That was flawless. It was. Let me switch gears here. Let me ask you a question. You ever won that one? All right. Hey. We know that. Have you ever even competed for one of these? Hold on. Have you ever been in the main event of WrestleMania before? Because I'm pretty sure I done did all of that. So that means I'm the most experienced main event of all time. But here's the kicker. I've been groomed since I was just a little boy. Not only by my father, but by your father too. Done with my story. There's more. Let's talk about your dad, huh? Easy. I have too much love and respect for that man to degrade him. He's done way too much for me. We spent a lot of time together. I said this many times before in interviews. The dream is the one that put the confidence in me. He's the first one that told me I had hit. Let me try to do a dream real quick. Baby, you have it. You couldn't get rid of it. You couldn't sell it if you wanted to. You are it. And we would talk for hours, and we would talk about everything. Literally everything. To be honest, it was a lot about, like, right now, what's going on in my life. He used to tell me about these main events, about being the guy, being the face of the company, main eventing WrestleManias. He called it all before. My God. He was the best. He really was. Hey, you want to know what he used to always say about you? Nothing. He never said anything ever about you, at least not when I was with him. I don't know about the maybe when Seth was in there, or Kevin Owens, or Becky. Maybe he talked about you all the time, but when I was in there, it was like you did not exist. And I know this is a lot, but God, I wish he was here right now. I know you miss him. I miss him too. I know he's not here anymore, but just know this. If there's anything that he didn't teach you, I will.
Oh my God. I'm not even playing on the same field. This is not chess. You didn't send Mr. Heyman to Raw to get inside my head. You sent him to relay and convey the real life situation. You sent him to tell me the truth. If that's the truth, then the truth is one of the fabled Dusty's kids is better than Dusty's actual kid. If that's the truth, then the truth is you are the son that he always wanted. And that changes absolutely everything, because it's not just a dream, it's not just an urge or a want or a desire or some story that needs to be finished. This becomes a necessity. You say I don't exist, I have to exist, and the only way that I can exist is by beating you at WrestleMania. So absolutely, Roman Reigns, sir, champ, may the better man win.
An explosive, emotional, blockbuster of a confrontation here tonight on Friday Night SmackDown. Cody Rhodes making it clear. It has become a necessity to beat Roman Reigns in 4 weeks